Hello everyone, Prithvi here from 7stone studio, back with another video tutorial. Today's guide is perfect for photography fans and anyone who enjoy working with motion graphics. The effects makes uses of Adobe Photoshop to cut out an image, then uses the timeline feature to convert the still pictures into a video. It's working by clipping the image into different area, then adding stubble movement so that the foreground and the background moves at different rate to create a slow motion panning effect. It works best with images where there is a clear contrast between the subject and the background. So choose a picture that has an obvious outline that you can trace around. Open the image in Photoshop, then select a pen tool and bring track around the main subject. Keep a path within a few pixels from the edge to avoid accidentally capturing any slithers of background in the cutout. When you have traced the image back to the starting point, close the path, then right click and choose make selection. Enter value of 0.5 pixels in the feathering option to eliminate the hard edges. Then copy and paste the selection into a new layer. Double click the background layer to make it a workable layer. Then hold the Ctrl or Command key by clicking the thumbnail of the cutout layer to load its selection with the background layer. Still selected, go to the Select, Modify, Expand and enter 10 pixels. Next, go to Edit, Fill and make sure the option is set a Content Aware. Photoshop will automatically fill the space. The best it can be erase the original subject. Toggle off the visibility of the cutout layer to see the result. It does not have to be perfect, but it will help discuss any area where the foreground and background become unaligned from the original position during the animation. Turn the visibility of the cutout layer back on and create a new document. Since the final effect is exported into a video format, I'm making a 1080 pixels document at 1920 and 1080 pixels. Switch back to the original document and select both layers. Drag them into a new document and position them centrally. Individually, select each layer and choose Convert to Smart Object from the right-click menu. This will allow us to scale the image down and back up without affecting the quality. Next, go to the window menu and select timeline. Make sure the option is set to create video timeline rather than create frame animation. Then click the button. Press the Ctrl T or Command T shortcut to transform, then hold Shift and scale the background to fill the majority of the canvas. Move the playhead to the end of the timelines, then click the little keyframe icon to set a new position. Transfer the background again and scale it up to slightly. Photoshop will automatically animate the size between the two keyframes for the duration of the timeline. Repeat the process with the other layer that contains a main subject. Add a transform keyframe at the start and the end of the timeline. and adjust the size of the layer. This time, scale the subject in your opposite direction. So, go from layer to small to intensify the parallax effect. Scrub the playhead back to the beginning, then press the play icon or spacebar to see the effect. First time it's play, it might be a little jumpy until it's rendered the timeline. But the second time should play through smoothly. The result is a cool stubble animation that the foreground and the background move at different rates to create the parallax effect. The final video can be exported by heading to File and select Export, then Render Video. Set the file name and change the preset to YouTube HD 1080p. It should be available if you have an Adobe Media Encoder installed as a part of the Premiere or After Effects from the full Adobe CC suite. This parallax effect is also worked with landscape images where there is a clear definition between the horizon and the object moving. It's worked exponentially well if the foreground, middle ground and background can be separated and moved independently. In this next example, I am creating a clipping of the rigid line and creating a timeline of a subject in a foreground, adjusting a main subject in a sky. The stubble scale on the main object layer, again some slight rotation and movement of the sky creates a cool effect when the animation is playing through. This time I added a couple of extra lightning effect layer, but the effect itself can be easily created by manually tapping a bunch of wild sponge with brush and adding some blurring and less the opacity. Okay, the trick is to adjust the keyframe just enough so they produce some stubble motion. You can always move your timeline playhead back over a keyframe and readjust the transformation, or you can switch the keyframe around so the transformation play in your opposite direction. A video timeline was created for all the layers, then each section was animated independently by adjusting the size and position. So I hope you have some fun with this parallax effect to bring your own photographs to life. It's provide a cool new way to experience your shots in a kind of pseudo video format as opposed to basic still in your slideshow. If you enjoyed the tutorial or learned any new tips, a thumbs up to help spread the word could be really appreciated. Don't forget to subscribe to the 7 Stone Studio YouTube channel. If you are new, please subscribe my channel to find plenty more tutorials. So as always, thank you very much for watching my video.